And we got to the top of the bridge. We saw a sea of blue, Alabama state troopers. And we continued to walk. We came within hearing distance of the state troopers. And a man identified himself and said, "I'm Major John Cloud of the Alabama state troopers. This is an unlawful march. You will not be allowed to continue. I give you 3 minutes to disperse and return to your church." And one of the young people walking with me, leading the march, a man by the name of Hosea Williams, who was on the staff of Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr., said, "Major, give us a moment to kneel and pray." And the major said, "Troopers, advance." And you saw these guys putting on their gas masks. They came toward us, beating us with nightsticks and bullwhips, tramping us with horses. I was hit in the head by a state trooper with a nightstick. I had a concussion at the bridge. My legs went out from under me. I felt like I was going to die. I thought I saw death. All these many years later, I don't recall how I made it back across that bridge to the church. But as I got back to the church is full to capacity. More than 2,000 people on the outside trying to get in to protest what had happened on the bridge. And someone asked me to say something to the audience. And I stood up and said something like, "I don't understand it, how President Johnson can send troops to Vietnam, but cannot send troops to Selma, Alabama, to protect people who only desire to register to vote."